or the equipment actually or the arrangement you can use. So this is actually your thing that circuit breaker, and this one is given by what? CB. But remember that, and CB here we are providing with isolator, here also having what? Isolators are there. I'm not showing that one. Clear? So now under healthy condition, now from this bus bar, suppose you take a 220 kV bus bar. From this 220 kV bus bar, the current will pass to the transformer, transformer to the consumer. Here, okay. Step down, after that we are going to the finally it reaches to the consumer. Right. So during this process, circuit breaker must be in closed condition. Right. Now, whenever the current is actually on this primary side, I am taking this is the primary current. And this is the secondary current for this CD. Now this CD is having certain ratio. Okay, this may be 400/5 amps or 100/1 amps like this, PD is provided. And the secondary current is actually circulating in this particular coil. This coil is called as which one?
Relay coil.
Right. Now here, the drip contacts are on the open condition. You can observe here, in this drip coil, this loop you can observe, this loop, is it a closed loop one or open one?
Open.
It is open. Whenever it is open, what the current? Current is. Okay. So under healthy condition is normal condition. In our terminology, actually we are calling as blocking condition. So whenever actually I am taking a block means normal condition. Right. Drip means faulty condition. From now onwards, block and drip, you can remember this terminology. Right. Whenever you use a blocking condition under this, what is about the drip contact? This is actually these two are what called as the drip contacts. This drip contacts are open or closed? What is circuit breaker? Circuit breaker is here, right. Now, this is the second case. Now a fault is occurred. Fault is occurred. What happened to the primary current now? Increased. This is a fault current. Then primary current will be increased. Then secondary current will also be increased. Whenever it increased, then this relay coil will be more magnetized. This magnetic energy will try to attract this. This is what is called as a plunger. This is whatever is there. This one is called as a plunger. Okay. This plunger will be attracted by this magnetic force. Then it will be closed. Right. So whenever it is closed, right, then it will move like this. So it is actually moving. Whenever it is closed, what happens to current? Are equal. Here, whenever the current is not equal, because it is closing the head to, current is not equal to zero, then this strip coil will be magnetized. Whenever it is magnetized, it will try to attract this circuit breaker, then automatically circuit breaker move downwards. Here, it will actually open this. Okay, whenever it is open, now the faulty section will be isolated. Okay, this is what the process is actually going on. Repeat once again, if any fault is occur under this condition, current primary current will increase, secondary current will increase, so that relay coil current will be increased, more energized, then drip contact will be closed, drip contact will be closed, means this current will be not equal to zero, drip coil current is also magnetized, it will try to open the circuit breaker. So under faulty condition, what is about drip contact? Closed and circuit breaker is open. So whenever I am saying the drip means drip contacts are closed, and whenever open means actually healthy means block means open. So actually in normal, if we visit any substation, they will not use this terminology like drip contacts are closed, so that actually it is an open condition, circuit breaker is open. And drip contacts are opened, so the circuit breaker is closed. They will use normally the terminology like this, is what called normal open, NC, NO. They will give that normal closed. This is done by what? Here, NO, NC. They will give that NO, it is NO, it is NC, it is NO, it is NC. Like that, they will actually discuss the terminology. In the home interview they will ask, what do you say NO in substitute? Don't say that I don't know. Here okay, NO means what? Normal open. Normal Here, this is actually what? That way in this one. Now you can observe in this one. In this case, what a sequence you can observe. Before this point is occurred, circuit breaker is in closed condition. You see that here. No need to write this one, just I will give it more to you later. So then you understand. Now you can observe here. If there is no fault for different types of animals, now take the position. Right. When I am in Robert, a person character can be judged whenever he is in darkness or whenever he is alone. Okay.
Right.
Now you can observe here. Now this is actually the condition. If there is no fault, what actually the concept is, what is the total fault clearing time? What is the meaning of what is total fault clearing time? What a sequence, understand here. I'll give the note later, understand here. Suppose see that the fault is occur, then the primary current will increase, secondary current will increase, then it is energized. Then the grip point drives are so the time between the instant of fault to the closing of grip point drives, this time is what called relay time. We are relay operating time. Right, okay. Whenever this relay is operated, then it is energized. This energized means it inside is having some mechanical energy. It will try to open the circuit breaker. So now this circuit breaker is open. So the time between instant of closing of grip contacts to the opening of this one circuit breaker, this is what called circuit breaker mechanical operating time. This is what called which one? Mechanical operating time. Whenever this mechanical operating will occur, automatically it will initiate some arc will be produced. This is what called arc is produced. So whenever the arc is produced, what we have to do, the we have to supply some medium like what? SF6 gas. This SF6 gas will try to quench the arc. Clear? Okay. The time between opening of circuit breaker contacts up to quenching of arc, which is what called arcing time. Here, okay. So, what is the total now? Then only fault is cleared. Clear? Then only current is becoming what? Zero. So, this current is now, it is becoming how much? This current is becoming how much? Zero. Right. So, what is the total time now? What is the first time? Delay time. Delay time is the instant of fault due to the what? Closing of grip contacts. Is what called? Relay time. Next one. From the instant of closing of grip contacts to the opening of circuit breaker, when circuit breaker pole is what called pole contacts, is called as circuit breaker mechanical operating time. Right. What next one? Arcing time. The time between instant of opening of circuit breaker contacts to the quenching of complete arc by using some medium, this one is called as arcing time. Okay, this is complete three timings. Complete one is called as a fault clearing time. You're okay, right? That point you know. Total fault clearing time. Total fault clearing time. Equal to relay time plus circuit breaker mechanical operating time plus arcing time plus arcing time. Plus arcing time. Okay. We have that thought of relay time. Relay time. Relay time. The time between instant of fault, the time between instant of fault to the closing of, to the closing of, time between instant of fault to the closing of trip contacts, trip contacts of the relay, trip contacts of the relay is called relay time. Is called relay time. Next one, circuit breaker mechanical operating time. Circuit breaker mechanical operating time. The time between, time between instant of, time between instant of closing of trip contacts, closing of trip contacts to the opening of circuit breaker contacts, opening of circuit breaker contacts is called circuit breaker mechanical operating time. Is called circuit breaker mechanical operating time. Okay, next one, arcing time. Arcing time. The time between, the time between instant of opening of circuit breaker contacts, instant of opening of circuit breaker contacts to the complete quenching of arc, complete quenching of the arc is called arcing time. Is called arcing time. Okay. Now, you can observe here. So, for this complete process, how much of time it will take for this complete part clearing? Yes, we will analyze. Simple analysis will be here. Okay, don't worry about the waveform kind of. Okay. Just see that here. Suppose if there is no fault, if there is no fault, then circuit breaker is in closed condition and we are feeding for this feeder. We are feeding some voltage and we are feeding some current. That means we are feeding some power of VI into R. Right, okay. Now what are the frequency we are supplying is this here? 50 Hz is the frequency we are supplying. So assume that this is time t equal to 0. Before time t is less than 0, before the time t is less than 0, here we are actually having a signal of this current signal having a frequency of what? 50 hertz of signal. You know, okay? When we have a 50 hertz of signal is available, this 50 hertz of is the current signal of what? IP. This is actually before point. Right. Now, what happened now? This is actually the voltage signal. This voltage signal also some value of the frequency, same frequency of this one. It is actually having the same frequency of 50 hertz signal. Right. Now, this is actually normal signal frequency. Suppose if you measure what is the voltage and current across this circuit breaker poles. So, the current is normally flowing. So, that is the current signal as it is. What is about the breaker voltage across this voltage becoming 0? Because if it is in the closed or open, it is closed. You are right. Now, assume that here, instead of a transmission line, you can think of a generator also, same part. If any fault is occurred, for example, if any fault is occurred, this is a fault. So, what is the behavior of this IP, primary current or fault current? Here, this will be increasing. This is increasing, you have studied in generator topic, clear, transient condition of generator. In this, you are getting a characteristic like this. Right, okay. In this, what you are having is different terminologies. You are using is IF double dash. Next one is what you are having? IF dash. Next one is given by what? Some component of what? This is actually given by IF. You are okay. This is what one? Subtransient. Transient and one is what? Steady state. Okay. Now, so whenever the fault is occur, this fault current is increasing very higher value, having a different combination of this one, fault current, subtransient current, transient current and the different steady state currents are. Now, during this process, if for this fault is to increase, then we have to do the delay current has to be increased, secondary current, then trip contacts have to be closed. So, assume that it is taking for this trip contacts to close, assume that the least one is 1 cycle. So, what the 1 cycle indicates what? How many times? 20 milliseconds. Because of 50 hertz signal is there, for this 1 by 50 will get how much? 20 milliseconds. So, here at this point, here the relay contacts is closed. Clear? Trip contacts are closed. Assume that least timing update. Right. Next one. When the trip contacts are closed, immediately what will happen now? Circuit breaker is mechanical operating is there. Circuit breaker is not opening. So, circuit breaker is not opening. Whenever it starts opening, it will take minimum of 1 second. We are normally having 2 cycles also. Right. So, if you take here, assume that I am taking here, this is around 1.5 cycle I am taking. Right. 1.5 cycle. At this time, circuit breaker is open. Here, circuit breaker is open. Here, whenever the circuit breaker is open, then what is producing? RP is producing. So, for your ease understanding, just I will show this one is the red color. R. Okay. This is actually the what? R thing is present. Right. So, this is the point actually circuit breaker is open. Circuit breaker is open, then what is the voltage across the circuit breaker now? Increase or not? Increase. Up to this point, what is the voltage? Voltage is across the circuit breaker poles. Okay, this voltage is 0. Now, here, what will happen now? You can observe. From this point, voltage will be increased. So, the relation between the voltage and current of an arc is of resistive character, that is in phase character. Okay, for this purpose, whatever the voltage is there, this voltage is also in the Now as the breaker arc quenching is actually reducing, arc quenching is reducing means current will start reducing. What happens to voltage? Voltage will be building up. So here actually voltage is building up, like slowly voltage is building up. So now what we are doing, whenever the circuit breaker is open, at this time, from this time, we are trying to send the which one? SF6 gas. You are okay? So just see that here. What is this time? Delay time. What this time? Circuit breaker? Mechanical operating time. Here. Now SF6 gas is we are impinging. Whenever actually it is producing some arc. Assume that it will take for complete quenching of the arc. Assume that it is taking around 1.5 seconds. Okay, 1.5 seconds nothing but 20 milliseconds for each second plus 10. What a total 10 milliseconds, 30 milliseconds. So at this time, now actually you are quenching the arc. Here the arc is quenching. Arc is quenching means you are trying to switch off the arc. Arc is completely switched off. What is the current? Current needs to be 0. So what you are expecting from now on board, we are expecting that this current should be half how much? 0. Yes. So this current needs to be how much? We are expecting that it should be 0. Is it okay or not? Here. So at this moment, whenever the arc is completely quenched, what is the voltage across the breaker pole? Maximum. Because the current is 0. Updated voltage drop across this one, voltage across the pulse will be maximum. So this is important. Now what will happen? This is becoming huge value of the voltage will take. Whenever this voltage is becoming very high value, immediately between these two breaker poles, high electrical field will be produced. Here, this high electrical field now will try to re-establish the arcing muscle. That means it will try to dislodge some of the molecules or electrons from the surfaces and it will try to re-establish the which one? Arc. Here. So what will happen? Now the arc will try to continue for this one. Okay. So whenever arc will try to continue, assume that in the next half cycle we are trying to quench. This process of quenching is we are going on. So, okay, whenever you try to quench, you will try to suppress the arc. Assume that after half cycle, now this arcing, you are trying to suppress from now onward, this arcing current is becoming how much? You are okay, right. So, here what will happen now? This voltage, whatever is rising, this is actually producing some transients in the system because of the system is consisting of inductor and the capacitor. Because if you think of a transmission line is having an inductor. Now you can think of like this, this is a bus bar. This bus bar is connected to a breaker. Breaker this side is connected to the what? Feeder. Are you imagine? This is a circuit breaker, just you can think of here. This is a bus bar. Bus bar is having certain potential. Now this is actually a feeder. What is the feeder voltage now? Feeder voltage is 0. What is bus bar? This pole voltage. Maximum. This is a 220 kV bus bar. This voltage is maximum. This voltage is what? 0. So these two breaker poles, will now it is working as a capacitor. Getting my point? Because of one plate, it is of what? Another plate. It is having what? Capacitor. And this is actually transmission line is having certain inductance. So because of this inductance and capacitance, these two will actually produce as transients in the system. Okay. So whenever it is producing the transients in the system, up to the arc is completely quenched, right? Afterwards, now the voltage is having a same sinusoidal signal. We are getting same sinusoidal signal will be we are able to get. This is actually having a frequency of how much? 50 hertz frequency. This frequency is very high. It is of actually is actually given Fn. Yes, sir, this is Fn. This Fn is depending on 1 by 2 pi under root of L by C. Is this is actually in terms of kilohertz, but it is available only for milliseconds. Then okay, that means this time, I am telling about this time. This time is available only for what? Very short time is available in milliseconds, but the frequency is what? Very high value. This is what we call as a natural frequency of the system. Now repeat once again. Now at this point, fault is occurred. If fault is occurred, then what you are having now? This current is the behavior of the current. So during this time, the relay is operating. The relay is operating, then it is actually takes 1 or 2 cycles for the circuit breaker to open. When the circuit breaker is open, producing an arc. Whenever the arc is produced, the voltage will build up. So this arc will continue for 1 or 2 cycles. Then we are trying to pinch the arc. When we are pinching the arc, then the arc pinching is we are trying to pinch up completely. But during this time, actually, when I try to pinch, current is becoming, arc is becoming zero, the voltage is becoming what? Huge value. This voltage, where actually we are getting huge voltage, which is re-establishing arc, this voltage is what current as a TRV, transient recovery voltage. This voltage is what for? Transient recovery voltage. This is also, we call it as rate of rise of re-striking voltage. Here, this is what call this one? Rate of rise of re-striking voltage. Here, so this transient recovery voltage having a frequency of, in terms of kilohertz of frequency, and assume that we are pinching the arc in the next, when half cycle or one cycle, if we pinch the arc, till the process of pinching is going on in the subsonics or medium, then becoming current is becoming how much? Zero. Here, so we are re-establishing the original frequency of 50 Hz signal. So this voltage, wherever we are recovering our original signal, this voltage is what we call it as a, which one? Recovery voltage. This is a transient recovery voltage. This is what? Recovery. Recovering the original signal. What is the original signal frequency? 50 Hz signal. Here, okay. Now, what the total arcing time will take for this example? It is taking 1 second for relay time, and it is taking around 1.5 second for the circuit breaker mechanical operating time, and it is taking 1.5 second or 2 seconds for the arc pinching time. So how many cycles it is taking? 1, 2, 3, 4. You're okay. It is taking around what? 4 cycles. 4 cycles means for the time?
80 milliseconds.
In the nameplates of the circuit breaker, you can observe they are putting as 5 cycles operation, 3 cycles operation. You're okay. What is the meaning of the 5 cycles and 3 cycles is? This is the meaning of this one. Are you able to understand? What is the different technology? What actually we are getting this process? Any doubt here? Right. No doubt? Whenever actually I am doing my bidder, at that time actually relay is in, I think already I told you, relay is in one semester, 1 year, and circuit breaker in another year. Clear? When after the completion of the bidder also, we don't know the what is relation between relay and circuit breaker. In actually in the labs, actually what you are doing in your labs, when you are doing a over current testing of by using over current relays, generally you are using a bulb. Yes, when the trip contacts are closed, then you cannot use circuit breaker physically. You are using bulb, automatically bulb will glow when the circuit breaker is closed. Okay, so we thought that okay, for controlling of the bulb, we are using relay. In one of my interview, actually one of my professor asked me, what is the function of the relay? It's the same thing, what I know, I explained it. Okay, use it for glowing the bulb, controlling the bulb. Only one person, there is no next person, bye bye. He understood how much actually, understood related to the relay. Same situation. Behavior of the arc, internal property of the arc is actually having a raised to behavior, for that you are having both are in increase. No, there is no phase shift, that is what I am saying, this one. In phase shift, it is having this component. What is actually, whenever see, okay, very good. Suppose see that, whenever circuit breaker is opened, at this time, current is reducing. What happened to voltage? Voltage is increasing. That is what we give you. But both are in phase shift kind of, there is no phase displacement. Here, if we take the graph for the voltage and currents of the arc, actually, you can think this is the current. This is the current here. Yeah? Right. What happens to the voltage? Whenever the current is zero, voltage is maximum. Voltage is maximum. Here, whenever the current is increasing, what happens to voltage? Decrease. Voltage is decreasing. Now, at this moment, whenever the current is changing from positive to the negative, it is zero. Once again, it is becoming maximum. So that it is becoming decreasing. This is the behavior of the arc, but voltage and current. Right. No, no, current is zero. Whenever current is zero at this moment, what is the voltage? Right. Whenever current is increasing, what happens now? The voltage is maintained to increase. Some extent. It has to be increased. It has to be decreased. I am not showing this one. Actually, this has to be decreased and becoming zero. It has to be decreased. Now, I can observe here. Suppose see that after some time, fault is cleared. Okay? So now the fault is cleared. Then what you have to do? You have to re-establish the supply to the consumer. For this pair, for this purpose, the trip point times you are supposed to reset. Otherwise, circuit breaker always in the open condition. So what they will do, it has been done manually. This reset, they will push it like this, and push it back automatically. This will get, when it is open, the current is becoming how much? Zero. Previously, current is not equal to zero. Now it is becoming, current is becoming what? Zero. Then, actually what they will do, this circuit breaker, they will actually close it, push this one circuit breaker. Push the circuit breaker, then it will automatically close. So, this circuit breaker is closed, now supply is extended to the consumer. Okay, this closing of the circuit breaker, they can do again by using different mechanisms. Either it may be a spring, or it may be a compressed air, or they can use motor also. Okay, by using this, they can close this circuit breaker. If nothing is available, they can take a rod and push it. Okay. If everything is failed, they can do that manually by using some rod. Right, okay. These are actually the establishment. Right. Now you can observe here, in this, we are having some terminologies there. Just, this is actually important related to circuit breaker concept also. Understand? Whenever any fault is occurred, the current is becoming huge, very high value. Here, in the first 1/4 of the cycle, this is a complete cycle. This one is what? 1/4 of the cycle. Whatever the current that is actually existing in the peak value, it is actually maximum value of the current that is existing. This current is what called making current. Here, making means actually. Where actually when this circuit breaker is, when for the initial 1/4 of the starting current is going as what? This current? An instant of what? Right. This is actually measured in peak value. Right. Now, this continues. Now, circuit breaker is opening. Circuit breaker is opening, and this, then it is producing arc. Arcing is nothing but heating. Then, the RMS value of the current. The RMS value of the current that is actually occurred whenever the circuit breaker is open. Open means well it has got breaking. Here breaking of the circuit breaker is what called open. This current is what called as a breaking. Here, so this is a which one? Making current. This is what? Breaking current. Right, okay. So This breaking current, because of RC is nothing but heating, breaking current is measured in RMS value. Breaking current is measured in what? You look at, right? This breaking current, how you can actually generally get all this one like this. Suppose see, listen this point here. Listen this one. Suppose the fault is there. Fault is there somewhere. You don't know where the fault is there. Here. For the first fault condition, relay is actually operating, the contacts are closed, and the circuit breaker is open. Okay? Circuit breaker is open. Now, the process is actually isolating the fault section. Here. Now, we don't know where is the fault. Someone make a call, okay sir, everything is fine. You can close the breaker. Right. So what you can do normally, you will reset the relay. You will reset the relay. And after that, you push this one and you are closing the breaker. But still the fault is there. You look at, close the breaker, still the fault is there. What is current going through this breaker now? Max value, minimum value? Max value. Still the fault is there. So, this current, whatever is actually produced, the fault current is there. At the instant of closing of the circuit breaker is what for the making of it. You're okay. Still the fault is there, but you don't know about the fault. Whenever you close the circuit breaker, what is the maximum instantaneous fault current flowing through the circuit breaker poles at the instant of closing of the circuit breaker is what the current making. Clear? What do you mean by breaking current is at instant of opening of circuit breaker, RMS value of the current is what called as breaking. What is the difference? What do you mean making? What do you mean what? Breaking current. Just note on that. The maximum or peak instantaneous current. Instantaneous fault current flowing through the circuit breaker poles, POLE. This is actually contacts are what called as poles. This is what called as a pole. Here, we take a three-phase system. R is having one pole, Y is having one, P is having. This is what called three poles. Three poles. Three breakers are there. Nothing but pole, nothing but breaker. Right. Circuit breaker poles. The maximum are peak instantaneous fault current flowing to the circuit breaker poles during closing time of the circuit breaker. During closing time of the circuit breaker is called making current. Is called making current. Okay. Suppose if it is multiplied with root 3 into V, making current is having some value. Here, current into voltage. What will get? Over. So that is actually what called as making capacity. The line voltage is VL, it is given by root 3 VL IL into cos phi. What will get normally? Power term. Here we are normally measured in terms of MV. You don't know what a power factor is, for the general vehicles, RT has very equal property. Generally we are expressing as what? Root 3 VI. This is what called this one? Making capacity. Here, okay, that's no wrong. It is also measured in. Is also measured in power units called making capacity. Power units called making capacity. You can write down making capacity equal to root 3 VL into root 3 VL into I circulating current, IMK. IMK is breaking current. This is breaking current. Okay. This is what called breaking ampere. In terms of this is an ampere. SMK are writing. What is SMK is making ampere. IMK is making current. VL is operating line voltage. So when you take you are using a bus bar voltage of 132 kV, 33 kV, 11 kV, so this is what point does what? Operating line. Breaking current. Breaking current. The RMS value of current flowing through the breaker. RMS value of the current flowing through the breaker. At the instant of opening of breaker poles, is called breaking current. Next one, it is also expressed in breaking capacity. Breaking capacity. Okay. Just in this one, you can put breaking is SBK. Actually, given. This is a breaking current, this is what? Breaking current. So normally if you take the making current and breaking current values, we do the process actually, this value is around approximately 2.55 times that of the breaking current. This is the relation between making current and the breaking current. Okay. Okay. Now coming to the relays, we will discuss first the complete part of relays. Got a basic idea what are different types of timings, there is actually how much of time it will take for the relay to operate for complete fault clearing. Right, okay. Now in this actually, for the relay to operate, we have to check certain conditions. What a condition is, whenever any fault is occurred, the fault is occurred, the current is flowing through the relay coil, the relay coil is energized and it tries to close the trip contact. Okay. Right. So for the certain amount of minimum current should pass the relay coil, then only it will try to pull the plunger. Okay. So So that minimum current which is actually required for pulling the plunger and goes in the trip contact, that is what is called as a driving or operating or what? Deflecting torque. Clear? So normally they are providing internally some spring is provided. The spring will actually produce a controlling or reshaping torque. Clear? Okay. So we have to send the power or the current has to be satisfied. Suppose you want to get a trip condition. You have to get the trip condition in. This one you have to remember. The deflecting torque must be operating torque much greater than what? Controlling torque or reshaping torque. Then only relay will operate. Next one. This one is what called as a torque condition. Whenever the deflecting torque is less than or equal to the reshaping torque, that is what called as a torque condition. You have seen in your labs also. Suppose actually in the labs actually try to recollect, when I have a disc type of relief, clear, the disc is rotating and actually tripping the trip contacts are closed. Whenever you reset the relay, disc will automatically come to zero or we are manually we are bringing the bringing to zero. Automatically come to zero. Who is bringing to the zero position? They are providing a getting the point. So the spring is always available. The spring is actually try to restrain. You try to oppose the movement of the disc. So when you want to move the disc, then sufficient torque must be there. The torque must be more than what? Reshaping torque. Then only it will try to move and close the disc contact. So okay, you want for deflecting torque is more than the controlling torque. Then only it produces a trip condition, drop condition, these are. In all the types of relays, we are actually, whenever actually I am giving the in the concept explaining, I will not show the circuit breaker everything. Just I will give the trip contacts are closed, then automatically you have to think that it is in a open ending circuit breaker. Here, okay, then we have to think that. Now, next one, what are types of relays? Resilient here. If you take the relays point of view, basically, the relays are actually classified in two groups. One is what called unit protection. Another one is non-unit protection. What is the meaning of unit protection? Let me explain or get the idea. Suppose we, you know that actually inside the transformer, we are using a relay what's called hook hole relay. In case of hook hole relay, what is the function of this one here? You see here, ignore about the spelling. Okay, right. You want the basic equation is what we get the equation is what? Hook hole relay. What is the function of hook hole relay? So, if any point is occurred within the transformer itself, the transformer winding, for identifying those fault conditions, this hook hole relay is used. Okay, right. So, suppose you can think of when I am a transformer, is one transformer and this is actually another transformer of capacity of 220 by 132. It is of what 132 by 32. I am using one buck valve cylinder, I am using one more buck valve cylinder. Right. If any fault is occur in this transformer internally, when the fault is occurred, which row, suppose I am giving transformer 1 here, this is a transformer 2. Which relay has to will operate? Whether this will operate or this will operate. So, this buck valve relay is only observing for the faults within the transformer only, within that particular unit. It does not take care of for the faults in other areas. This type of relay is what called as this one? Unit protection. Within that particular area, fault is there, then relay will operate. In other places, if the fault is there, does not take care. Okay. Suppose you take non-unit protection means it will take care of the faults in other areas also. For example, this will give a practical example understanding. Suppose I am using one circuit breaker here. Circuit breaker means relay everything is there, that you have to keep in mind. Okay, this is actually one circuit breaker, this is another one, this is another one. circuit breaker 1, circuit breaker 2, 3 and circuit breaker. Right. Normally, the circuit breakers are filled with SF6 gas. This SF6 gas, if it is normal case, you are maintaining around 5 kg. Here, and 7 kg also. 220 kg side is 7 kg and 130 kg side having around 5 kg. Right. Suppose circuit breaker pressure is 5 kg, if any point is occur, then circuit breaker hand axle will open, produces arcing, then this 5 kg of pressure will be sufficient for pinching of the arc. Suppose if the pressure value is less than 4 kg are there, less than 4 kg, during this time, if any fault is occurred, under this case, circuit breaker, if it is opened, produces arc. This arc, if the 4 kg of SF6 gas will be impinged, then it will not able to quench the arc. Is it okay? Then it will cause us overheating of the circuit breaker and finally damage of the circuit breaker. Is it okay? So, whenever this circuit breaker 1, assume that this circuit breaker 1, if the pressure of this circuit breaker, if it is less than 4 kg, less than or equal to 4 kg, if any fault is occurred in this region, what generally we are expecting, which breaker has to open? Circuit breaker 1 has to open. Here, circuit breaker 1 is open, but circuit breaker 1 is, what am I friend? The pressure is less than or equal to 4 kg. Then what will happen? For this, sorry, if normally what you think of, if the relay is fault is occurred, you are expecting that this circuit breaker has to open for isolating the faulty section. But because of the pressure of the SF6 gas, if it is less than 4 kg, then if we open this circuit breaker, then this much of pressure will not able to quench the arc, it will completely blast the circuit breaker. So under this condition, they will use one condition is what called as a lockout. Whenever the relay will actually, sorry, whenever the circuit breaker comes to lockout condition, even though the fault is there, it will happily pass the fault current without opening the breaker. It is in the closed condition only. It will say that if I open, I will blast. So that I am in lockout, someone will help. Clear? Okay. So now what will happen now? Circuit breaker 2, now it will try to operate. Suppose that one day the circuit breaker is in lockout condition. Then circuit breaker will say that I am in lockout so that I should not open. Then it will inform that circuit breaker 2 open. So circuit breaker 2 open, then circuit breaker 2 will say that I am already in lockout. Now you are in today you are lockout, I am in, but last 1 week I am in lockout. Clear? Then which one has to open? Circuit breaker 3 has to open. Clear? Okay. But see here, circuit breaker 3 is designed, suppose it is a transmission line 1, it is transmission line 2. It is designed normally for the fault within this area, transmission line 2 area. But if circuit breaker 1 and 2 are failed, then circuit breaker 3 will now operate and isolate the faulty section. Clear? Okay. Even though the fault is not in this section, but the fault is in another section, because of these breakers are not operating, so that it will actually operating, so that it is actually protecting not within its own unit, it is protecting the other units, for the faults in the other units. This is what the result is for non-unit protection. Are you understand? Clear? This one is the unit, this one is for non-unit protection. Clear? One point you have to understand here. Suppose see that This is very important, understand. If you think of, see the time in seconds, and these are fault currents. Fault current in answer to the answer to somebody. The fault current value is normally in the multiples of full load current. Suppose I am taking these two times the full load current, IL is full load current of the system, it is 5 times the full load current, and 8 times like this, ending up, it is 10 times the full load current. Some value I am taking. Now, practically you can think, the transformer is designed to carry a full load current of around 200 amps or 0.2 kiloamps. Right? Then under 0.2 kiloamps of current, then it will not getting any overheating, it will not getting any damage to the equipment, the winding or any insulation. When it will actually start damaging the equipment, internal winding, the current is more than that 200 amps. So it is 400 amps or 1 kiloamp like that. So for the transformer, if the current is small compared to full load current value, sorry, when 2 times the full load current, the probability or actually the time for complete burning of the winding will take more time, less time compared to 2IL and 10IL. 2L is less time, less current, so that will take more time. So here the time of operation for this current is what? For damaging of the transformer winding. Suppose the fault current is large. Fault current is large, what it will take? It will take less time. Is it okay or not? Here. Now it is actually having a proportional character or inverse character?
Inverse character.
So this is the characteristic of the transformer case. Transformer which is supposed to be burn out for this fault current. Is it okay? Right. Now, I have to protect this transformer. For this protection purpose, I am using different equipment. One is lightning arrester, another is fuse, another one is relay. All these are to be used. Now, you can tell me, what is the operating timings for those equipments compared to the transformer? It should be less. Suppose fuse is there. I am using fuse for protecting one motor. Clear? Whenever very heavy fault current is coming, which one should burn out first?
Fuse
or motor?
Fuse.
After burning the motor, fuse is starting burning. Can you do that like that? No. So, whenever if you take any transformer protection, any equipment protection, transformer, motor or generator, anything, the protecting device must have the character, timing operation must be well below this operation. Whenever well below this operation, this is actually lightning arrester, it is what you will take of fuse, or this is actually fuse, this one you will take it as a relay. Clear? Suppose, for example, instead of fuse is like this, instead of fuse is like this, here the character. Which one will burn first? Then fuse will burn. So, if I am using any relay I am using here, or fuse or lightning arrester, then this will first sacrifice for any fault condition, then only the equipment will be protected. It is having a proportional character, inverse character, everything. Inverse character. That is why in all our protecting equipment like relays, we are using IDMC character relay. What is IDMP? Inverse? Inverse, not indefinite. Inverse. Is that a proportional character or inverse character? Inverse character. Inverse definite minimum time. Inverse definite minimum time character R. Here. So, whenever the fault current is more, relays operate faster. The fault current is less, relays operate slower. Clear? Okay, it is having an inverse character. Are you able to understand now? Okay, this is actually how we have to design the equipment. Now, we will get one doubt here. What the doubt here is, just you can think of this example. You are having a generator. For the generator also I am using one circuit breaker. This is actually circuit breaker 5. Right. Now you can observe here. If any fault is occurred, this fault current is, who is actually feeding the fault current? Transformer is feeding or generator is feeding? Who is the source? Generator. Generator is actually feeding the fault current. It is a current, it will pass through all the circuit breakers and is the fault current that is actually feeding. Right, okay? Here. Now, I am using this circuit breaker 1 with a relay. Circuit breaker 2 with a relay. Circuit breaker 3 with a relay. 4 is also having relay. 5 is having relay. Yes, relays are actually employing for understanding is a disc type of relays. Right. Now, this is the relay 1 trip contacts. Relay 2 trip contacts like this. You can imagine like this. Okay, these are actually all the trip contacts of the relay. Assume that I am using a plunger. Plunger, you got the idea, right? Plunger is kept, don't draw this one, understand? For all the relays, now, whenever the fault is occur, now what is the behavior, understand here? What will happen? Every relay is experiencing the fault current. Is it okay? Now what will happen now? This key start rotating. This disc will also start rotating. These also start rotating, complete one, everything is start rotating. Here, okay. That means plunger is moving. You can think of this, plunger is moving. Moving to close the which one? Strip contact. Right. Now, if I am keeping this strip contact, sorry, I am keeping this plungers all are arranged like this, which one actually for operate first? Which one? Who is feeding? Who is actually feeding? Generator is feeding the fault current. When a generator is feeding the fault current, if I am arranging this one, now generator first, who is actually feeding the fault current? Generator relay, now it starts. Whenever it is moving, assume that it will take around 2 milliseconds, assume that for closing up or whatever actually you have seen that in the waveform, it is taking around 20 milliseconds. One cycle is using. Okay. Whenever it is closing the one cycle, then which one will operate first? The circuit breaker of this one will operate. This will actually operate. But where is the fault? Fault is far away from the generator, near to the generator. Far away from the generator. So, a fault in this room is actually creating circuit breaker of which is actually kept at Lucknow is open. Is it a good system? No. Whatever circuit breaker which is nearer to the fault that has to be operated first. If it is failed, then only it will go to the other circuit breaker which are actually kept backside. These relays are what called backup relays. These relays are called which one? Backup relays. So, what you have to do that, if this type of timing if you are able to maintain for all the relays, then we will getting a problem with because of the generator which starts operating first. What is the solution for this? You must maintain certain time delay between one relay with the other relay. For that, suppose it is in 90 degrees, this is actually with respect to the circuit contact, it is in 90 degrees, then this one will be at 135 degrees here. Now the fault is occurred. When the fault is occurred, every relay is now starts moving. So it will move from 270 to how much? 180. When it move by 270 to 180, then it will move by around 225 to 135. it will move by 180 to 90. It will move by, this value is what, 135 to 45. It will move by 90 to 0. Which one will operate first? This one will operate. Getting a point? Yes. So this relay will operate and try to open this circuit. Right. Just see that here. You can imagine the situation like this. Just I am drawing bigger one. Just see that. This is the respondent. This is our one plunger contact. This is actually plunger. From here to here, it is taking 9 degrees.
Ek bar time setting kar diye.
Okay. Visible. Right. Now, same plunger I am using here. What the angle it is around?
Fault beach
one. Now, same plunger is around 180. It is up
225.
It is up 270. All must start in the same direction. Clear? Clockwise. Just I will give the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here. Now we are energizing this one. When we are energized, which one will touch the trip contact first? First one. Here. Whenever first one is moved by 90 degrees, second will move from 135 to, it will also move by 90. It will come to 135 to 45. Is it okay? Are you getting or not? Yes. What is about third one? 180 to 90. Fourth one will come 225 to 135. Fifth one will come from 270 to 180. So which one will actually first operate? First one will operate. Is it okay? The first relay will operate and it will try to open this circuit breaker. Right? Suppose if this circuit breaker is in lockout, then the fault current is continuous or not? Fault current will continue. Then what is about this one? This is actually, now whenever it is reaching this one, it is closed, but breaker is not open. Breaker is not open till the fault current is continuous. So that it is actually closing this after certain time delay. Clear? After certain time delay means 135 to coming to 90, sorry 45, from 45 to 0 it will take certain time gap. Time gap is there. During this time gap, it will try to open. If it is open, fine. If it is not open, then this one. If it is not open, then this one. This will open, then this one. If it is also not open, generator gone. Clear? Okay. So, whenever you are protecting one equipment, whatever the relays are there, all the relays timings, relay 1, relay 2, relay 3, relay 4, all the relay timings must be much less than the equipment burning out timing. Here, okay, don't think that actually when our relay 1 is operated and relay 1 is actually failed, relay 2 is not operating, by the time transfer will burn out, then relay 2 is not operating. This is not the case. Okay, like that, what they will do is they will protect the equipment with, this is what called time grading. Time grading. We are providing this time delay between what? One delay to the what? Another delay. This is what called this one? Time grading. Time grading is normally provided for the non-unit protection type of delay. You have some idea now? Terminology try to understand. When you are reading the textbook, primary relay, backup relay, time grading, current grading, you are watching this one. But physical meaning is the physical meaning of it. Clear? So this is actually called as primary relay, and these are all what called as the backup relay. For the circuit breaker 2, if you take a primary relay, this is actually backup relay. Clear? Okay. Right? This will actually follow this curve for protecting the. Right, one more point here. Suppose see that. Whenever the fault is occurring in the circuit breaker, one, this fault current is very high with respect to this circuit breaker one or relay one. Because of the resistance is what? Small value. Simple logic you can understand here. If you think of the fault current, you see, any fault current is actually given by V by Z1, right? Any current, energy, V by Z. Now, you can think of here, this is a generator, and this is actually a transformer, and this one is a transmission line. This is actually a transformer like this. Okay, the same thing, same setup you can just take some of it. Suppose you that, for this, if you draw the reactance diagram, reactance diagram means you have to remove the transformer, put only the reactance. Here, so the generator is actually given by some voltage source. Generator is having some internal resistance, is a generator internal reactor. And generator is connected to what? Points actually you are drawing this type of diagram very more. Okay. Transformer. Transformer is represented with an equivalent of what? XT1 transformer. Transformer followed by what? Transmission line. This is transmission line 1. One not transmission line 2. Transmission line 2 is followed by another transformer. This is actually transformer 1 we can put is 2. And it is followed by a transmission line 1. And finally this is the line. So this diagram is what called as a reactance diagram. You are okay. Suppose see that. If any fault is occurred here. Any fault is occurred. Right. So now another fault is occurred, then if you write down normal fault current equation. How many reactors are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, write down normal fault current equation. IF is given by V by XT plus XTL plus XT1 plus XT2 plus XTL2 plus XTL1 plus XT1. See the total impedance, see the voltage is V. Here. So, if the fault is at this point, from the respect to generator, the fault current magnitude is smaller or lower, larger. Because of this value is what? Large value. Suppose, if the fault is very closer, for example, fault is occurred here. This is actually IF2, this is IF1. What is IF2 now? IF2 is given by V by? You're okay. Now you can tell me now, IF2 and IF1, which is larger, which is smaller? IF? Because of XC only one term. Okay, you are having so many terms are there. For example, just for easy understanding, just I am taking one unit. P is one unit, everything is also one unit. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. How much will get? 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is what the fault current? 0.2. Here, what is the value? 1 by 1. This value is how much? 1. Which is higher now? So IF2 is much higher than what? IF. Is it okay? Here. So because of this fault control, if the fault is nearer to the source, then the fault current is higher. If the fault is far away from the source, fault current is what? Yes. Is it okay? Right. Now you can observe here. This is this point, this point. Suppose if the fault is occurring here. If the fault is occurring here, then what is about the, this relay sitting? This relay is sitting at which value? 270. When the relay sitting is at 270, then what is about relay? Relay is operating slowly and open in the breaker. Then by the time, generator will be getting overheated. Can you find? Here, this relay is actually designed as a backup relay for the faults of what? At far away from the generator. Is it so or not? This is a backup relay setting. You look at, when the fault is occur very close to the generator, then the relay is experiencing fault current magnitude is more or less more, or the current is more than the operating torque is proportional to the fault current square. Here, okay. So then what will happen now? This torque will produce a huge amount of torque will produce, even though the setting is kept here, relay will operate very faster. Relay will operate very faster and open this. Here, so whenever this fault current is small, just see that here, fault current is large, the operating time is less. Fault current is fault current is large, operating time is should be less. Fault current is small, what is operating time? Operating time is. Okay, so even though setting is kept like this, whenever the fault is very closer, this will pass in the routine because of depleting charge in proportion to what? That is why it is having what? It must charge. Let us look at how it is done. Any doubt here? Here, right? Now, can what on you? So, take some more. Types of relays, this one. Unit production. Backup relays. primary and the backup relays. Are coordinated, primary and backup relays are coordinated for complete protection of the system. For complete protection of the system. Protection of the system. By providing time delay. By providing time delay between these relays, between these relays to operate, between these relays to operate in case of faults. This is called time grading. For time grading. Okay, next one, order. Current grading. Current grading. Current grading. The difference in current. Difference in currents between the primary and backup relays, between the primary and the backup relays, are maintained for proper protection of the system and to avoid mal operation of the relay, mal operation of the relay, MAL, I'll explain what it means, mal operation, MAL, correct, mal operation of the relays, is it practical?
To avoid the mal operation of the relays.
Within brackets, relay is operating without fault. Relay.
Repeat, sir.
Okay. And to avoid the mal operation of the relay, within brackets, you can note down. Relay is operating without any fault. Relay is operating without any fault. What the meaning of mal operation is, suppose normally relays are designed to protect the system in case of any fault. But sometimes what will happen, because of settings of the relays are wrongly kept, because of internal damage, or because of mechanical obstruction. Listen. After that, you can imagine something. Right. Understand. Whenever you can think of the relay's point of view here. So, whenever actually the fault is occurred, relay has to operate for the particular fault only. But relay is not responding and it is actually producing, extending the fault. That is some cases. Some cases, there is no fault, relay is actually starts operating. That should not occur. Here, this is what is called as a mal operation of relay. That is, that's why you can remember. Yes, see that here, but then I shall give current grading. What will be current grading? After it will take break. Just think of it. Then here. Okay. Now listen here. This is a circuit breaker and this is bus bar. Suppose you can think of it is 30 kV bus bar in which you are providing with some feeder. Okay? it is actually feeder 1, feeder 2, feeder 3. This one is also provided with some circuit breakers. Circuit breaker means relays are there. Suppose for the feeder 1, the full load current, see the full load current is of 100 amps, it is also of 100 amps, it is of 200 amps. Right. Now, if I use this relays for this circuit breakers 1, 2, 3 for the feeder, that circuit breaker means you are having the CD is there and relay, every setup is there, that you can always imagine, right. Now this circuit breaker 1 will operate for the fault current of 150 amps. This will also operate for the fault current of 150 amps and this will operate for the fault current of around 300 amps. Here. So if any fault is occurred in this particular feeder, full load current is 200 amps, then if this full load current is exceeding the 300 amps, then this relay will operate and open the circuit breaker. You are okay? Right. Now, you can just see that here, it is 100, it is 100, 100, 200. What is the total current? 400. So, here, the full load current of this transformer is of what? 400 amps. Then you can tell me for this circuit breaker to operate, what is the setting value I have to use for this circuit breaker? It should be more than 400, less than 400. It should be more than 400. You're okay. Right. It should be more than 400 means around, assume that I am keeping around 600 amps. Here. So if this current, if it is more than 600 amps, then relay will start operating. Are you clear or not? Now see the setting values here. The feeders having different setting values, lower setting value, that 300, 150, 150. But this relay is having a what? Higher value of setting value. So the current values are same or different? Current values are different. This is what called current varying. You have to understand now. This one is having what? Current reading. This delay setting is 300 amps. This delay, if we are keeping that, it is also, for example, let's see that here. See, this is this point here. Suppose, if I am keeping this one, it is around, I assume that from 500 amps. Here, 500 or 400 amps, if I am using this 400 amps, is using. Whenever full load current is there, but every full load current circuit breaker starts operating. Is it a fault? No. It is not a fault, but circuit breaker is operating. Here, okay. So what you have to do is the setting. Setting must be more than this transformer full load current. That you have to use this one in the what? Here, okay. That is what it's reading. Right? This example is one more. Okay. So these are the some of the points you have to remember. For the relays, what is the backup, what is the primary, unit, non-unit. Here. Next.